Hey, it's Greg from Scholar Farms, and I'm going to go through a quick unboxing of the new Phantom 4 Multispectral Drone by DJI. So we're going to go ahead and take it out of the box and take a look at what comes with this particular kit. This is one of a couple of boxes that come with it. This is just the drone itself, but we also have the RTK base station as well as a tripod that comes with it. So let's take a look at the drone. So this is a standard Phantom 4 size of the drone. What's different is really the RTK antenna and then the camera that's on it. This is a purpose-built vegetation or plant mapping camera or narrow band multispectral camera. We'll talk about that in just a bit. So the RTK antenna on here is a better GPS that does corrections, so we can do very precise mapping. So if I map on one day versus another day, all those pixels are going to align within a couple of centimeters instead of a couple of meters like a standard GPS on a drone. We also have an irradiance sensor on here. This will tag all of my photos with the incoming light data. So as the drone is flying, the sun is shining down, but it may be a sunny day or a cloudy day. And in order to correct the amount of light that's coming into our lenses, we need to know how much light is coming down from the sun. And we take the difference between the two and we can do radiometric corrections is the terminology for that. That really helps us compare our plants from one day to the next day, even if the lighting conditions change. We'll go ahead and take off this gimbal holder here, and we can go ahead then and look at the camera. You'll notice that there's six lenses on this camera. There are five narrow bands, as well as one RGB camera. They're all 2 megapixels. So we have red, green, blue, red edge, and near infrared. Those are your narrow bands for doing vegetation indices like NDVI or NDRE or many other indices that are out there. There are dozens. We can also trigger and take a color photo at the same time. So that's a nice feature of this particular camera. And so we get 6 photos every time it triggers, which ends up being a lot of data. So we have 2 batteries that come with this drone. So we have 1 battery in the drone itself, as well as a 2nd battery here that comes with this particular setup. These are the high capacity batteries, but what I suspect is that you're going to need to order a lot more batteries. This feels a lot heavier than a standard Phantom 4, and so I think you're going to see reduced flight times, and I'll keep you posted on what the average flight time that I'm getting. The rest of the kit is pretty standard. So we have our controller here. This is where we're gonna put our tablet for doing our automated missions. We're using Ground Station Pro, and we're using an iPad, and so this is just your standard controller here. We have our chargers here then for our batteries, as well as a range of cables. And then we have a 3-battery multi-charger that comes with the drone. So you can charge up to 3 batteries at the same time. I happen to have another one of these for my other Phantom 4 Pro. So I'll probably charge 6 batteries at a time and take them all out in the field, given that I do a lot of flying. You have extra sets of propellers as well. So you get a single set and then a couple extra sets that are in here. And then you have your info guide here for the setup of what comes in the kit, as well as your instructions in the manual for how to get up and running. But I suspect many of you, if you're buying this platform, you're probably advanced users. You already know how to fly a drone, but there's lots of information in here. What I don't see is typically there's a card that would come with drones that would give you logins to the software that come with the platforms. And so in this case, we have 3 different software. We have our long-term extended care, so DJI Shield. We have a year of DJI Ground Station Pro that comes with it, as well as we have a year of DJI Terra for the image processing. So I found that that was a little confusing when I first opened this up, that that wasn't in there. But once I logged into the app and registered the drone on my DJI account, then I got an email for the year of Terra. I got the coupon code from the enterprise dealer that I bought it for the Shield software. And then Ground Station Pro, as soon as I logged in and put in the serial number of this drone, it gave me that free year. So I encourage you, once you get it, go ahead and open up your iPad, log in and register the drone with your DJI account. And those steps then will be automated for you and connected to your email. So that's the drone. Let's look at the base station then. So there's 2 big boxes that come. I've already opened one of them, and that is the tripod that comes with the base station. And so it's a nice, actually pretty heavy duty, beefy surveyor tripod. And then at the end here, we'll slide the base station down in and lock it into place. And we're typically setting up the base station ahead of time in order to allow it time to get a lock and start doing the GPS corrections. And so once you set it all up, then you don't want to move it before you do your automated mission. And so here we have the top of the base station. This is the standard base station that comes with the other DJI RTK for RGB. And so we have two pieces here. They just screw together. And so this one just has a precision point at the end that you would then slide into your tripod and then screw on and mount the top here. And this has the RTK antenna on here. And so what this is doing is real-time kinematic corrections. So it's correcting for atmospheric distortion and other timing difference that can skew your GPS data. That's then tagged onto your photos. So standard drones are off by a couple of meters or so. This is going to correct that so you're off by a couple of centimeters. So if you want to fly repeatedly and map and make sure that that tree is the same tree every time or that plant is the same plant every time, you're going to need to use RTK or ground control or other correction methods. You have the battery bay here as well as a level, little level bubble here to make sure that it's all leveled up. And then we have our batteries. So we get two different batteries here for as well as a charger. And so we'll go ahead and you can plug these in and turn them on and then set up your base station that way. If you need more batteries, you can just buy these. They're fairly affordable relative to other DJI batteries for getting multiple batteries out in the field, but this should last you a really long time. This power doesn't draw that much just doing that kind of GPS corrections. Then we have our manual in here, as well as some other bits and bobs that we can talk about as we walk through the different process of setting it all up and getting started with our mapping. We can walk through the specifics of that in other videos. Okay, so that's a wrap on the new Phantom 4 Multispectral RTK. I hope you found that interesting. I'm Greg with Scholar Farms, excited to get this up in the air and compare it, the data from this camera, to some of the other multispectral cameras we've been flying with. So I'll keep you posted as I learn about this new platform and run it through its paces. So we'll talk to you again soon.